seeing things that are new.
And seeing animals right from the zoo.
D, lots of celebrity interviews. D,
and many super kids too.
I,
it's entertainment, the best to be found.
And
as much fun as a merry-go-round.
G,
we're gonna keep you spellbound. That spells kitten.
Shari Grewe.
And I'm Steve Smith.
Today on Kidding Around, we'll talk to a 9-year-old boy who raises birds. We'll hear the Apparition Band.
We'll find out all about sea lions at the Brookfield Zoo. We're going to make some easy summertime desserts and lots, lots more.
So be sure to stay with us for lots of fun today on Kidding Around.
Kidding Around will return after these messages.
Rummy!
Not so fast. What's that lump in your pocket?
This? It's Tidal Wave, the big soft liquid center bubble gum.
It is a big chunk.
With a giant burst of flavor from the very first bite.
But why do they call it Tidal Wave?
It is! Yeah, the Tidal Wave! It is!
Tidal Wave bubble gum!
It's a flash flood of flavor from the very first bite.
It's Arnold.
Look out! Here comes Short the Stylish!
And more than anything, humble.
Means that I'm a get-down, really cool little dude, we're talking the same lingo.
He's the one and only, still telling it like it is.
Don't worry about it, Dad. You've been wrong before. You'll be wrong again.
And the youngest member of America's favorite, well, different family.
Just lucky we're lovable.
Different Strokes.
Hey.
Different Strokes, Thursday at 8 on Channel 5.
You're in the hot, burning center of the galaxy.
School full of flakes.
We have a reputation that's based upon excellence.
In this school, you gotta be tough.
I didn't even think I could fit in here. But I can, and I do.
Trying? That's all they really teach here.
It's not what you know, it's who you know.
I'm not gonna blow it on drugs, guns, and nothing else.
Don't you just want to take him home and put him on your mantle?
This is great!
Not just any school, not just any TV show. Fame.
Thursday at 7 on Channel 5.
It can go 50 miles per hour without brakes. It can go 30 miles per hour in traffic. It can go 35 miles per hour without seatbelts. So don't get your child a skateboard without a helmet, elbow pads, knee pads. Don't give your child a bike without teaching rules of the road. And be sure your child skates on even pavement, because falling isn't fun. For free safety information, Right Wheels, Washington, D.C., 20207.
Now back to Kidding Around.
Oh, welcome back. And believe it or not, we have come to the end of another Kidding Around season.
My gosh, it's gone by so fast.
Phew!
Ooh, that's right.
But this year we have talked to more celebrities, I think. We've had great guests.
Oh,
we found out about all different kinds of animals.
And speaking of animals, over the summer, everybody, I think, is going to have a lot more time with them. You know, they're going to be home more. And
did you ever get your pet
I
dog,
sure
by the
did.
Way?
I never told you,
yes.
But I did.
What did you name him?
Benji.
Oh,
pretty
nice.
Original,
yeah.
Huh? So, he's great.
Great.
Cockapoo.
Great. Oh, how cute. Well, maybe you'll even get more guests over the.
Did you hear that, Mom?
More pets, I mean, more pets.
Well, I met someone recently who has a whole bunch of animals at his house, and he too is going to be real busy this summer. I'm with 9-year-old Eric Davis, and we're visiting his home here today in Glendale Heights. Hi, Eric.
Hello.
How you doing? Nice
Fine.
To be here. I understand you have a lot of animals here with
yes.
you today. How many do you have exactly?
81. And a lizard.
Those are birds, right?
Yeah, 81 birds, a lizard, a horse, and a couple chinchillas.
Oh, you have a variety of things then.
Yes.
How'd you ever get involved in getting so many animals?
Well, my sister first started out with the rabbits, and then went to other birds, and then I caught on with her.
I see. Well, today we're going to talk about your many birds that you have, because you do have a lot of them. So why don't you tell me about the different kinds you have and maybe a little bit about each of them, okay?
Okay. All right. First, we have the peacocks, and they come from India.
Mm-hmm.
And they tails grow to 80 to 92 inches.
You're kidding. They are beautiful animals.
Then we have the Amherst that come from Tibet, and they're known for the prettiest ones here. And their tails are real colorful, and they corn and they are just like almost everybody else.
Are you able to tell the difference from a male and female just by looking at the colors?
Yes, the male is always the prettiest, and the female is always dark color that she can blend into the ground, and that the male can attract females.
Okay, I see. Let's move on. Okay. What do you have here?
Wood ducks, and they come from America. And they were almost extinct at one time, so you need a license nowadays to own them.
Oh, okay.
And we have goldens. They come from China.
And they're you have a lot of those.
Yeah, we had babies and they multiplied. And we have lots of babies that come from eggs. Oh, there's an egg right now.
Oh, can we get it? Is it an egg that we look at?
Want to hold it?
Sure, sure. Don't want to let any of them get out. All right. Can you get it?
Yeah.
Do you know when that egg was laid? Just recently, or?
Yes, just recently, because before they didn't lay yesterday, so we take them and have hens hatch them.
I see. They aren't too big.
No.
Oh, those are neat. What do you do with them after you get them?
We have a hen hatch them, because these guys won't hatch them because they're not out in the wild.
Oh, I see.
They have to be out in the wild in order to hatch them.
Oh, okay.
And then we have the silvers.
And what are those? Where are they from?
They're from Asia, and they're known for the silvery feathers around them.
Those are pretty too.
Yeah. We have guineas that come from India and Africa, and they're known for telling the others that there's some predator in the territory.
Mm-hmm.
And we have quail, Californian quail, and they eat bird seed. That we feed them out of, and then we have doves, and we feed them bird seed, and they're known for the ring around their neck. That's why they're called ring neck doves.
I see. So you get them pretty much from all over the place, huh?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We have rabbits, and then chickens and pigeons.
So you got a whole variety of things. As far as their eating habits go, what do you feed them? Because I know you mentioned corn, but what else?
Layer. It's a variety of food mixed together.
What do you do during the winter? Do you leave all the birds out here, or do you have to take them in somewhere?
No, we leave them out here, and we give them corn to generate heat and lots of straw.
Oh, that's great. Keeps them kind of warm then during the winter.
Yes.
Do you ever enter any of these birds in fairs?
Yes. The 4-H fair, we enter them, the rabbits and chickens, and then the pheasants.
Are they pretty easy to work with or kind of difficult?
Well, the pheasants are difficult and the rabbits and them are easy.
Oh, well, that's good. Have they won any ribbons?
Yes.
Have they? That's great. Do you think you'd ever want to make a future career of training all these birds?
Yes, take care of them and be a veterinarian.
Well, that's great. You got a great start here, Eric.
Okay.
And I wish you the best luck. Thanks a lot for sharing your nice feathered friends with us today. Hope you have a wonderful summer.
Okay.
Oh, that's great.
Wasn't that wonderful?
Hats off, Eric. Can you imagine taking care of that many animals?
Oh, that'd be kind of difficult.
Holy cow. Well, right now we have a band to hear from. It's made up of five guys from Schaumburg who call themselves Apparition.
They'll play an original song called Prelude to Overture. Now here's Apparition.
Thank you.
Apparition Band! Let's find out who the band members are. We'll start with our keyboard player. Name and age.
Don McCullough, age 13.
Thank you, Don. We'll scoot over here to the bass player.
Ken Mathis, age 14.
All right, Ken. Back to the drummer.
Chris Kurt, age 13.
Thanks, Chris.
Dan DeMonis, age 14.
Okay, Dan. And finally?
Mike Malala, age 14.
Mike, how long have you been together as a group?
Around a year and a half.
And the name of the band is real intriguing. How did you come up with the name Apparition?
Well, Ken came up with it, and it means a ghostly image.
Is that how you see yourselves, as a ghostly image, you think?
Yeah, sort of.
Sort of? This was an original song, right?
Yeah.
Did you write it? Did you write it as a group?
I wrote, part of it, and we all put in.
So it was a group effort.
Yeah.
What about the future? Do you think you're going to write more songs together?
Yeah, we have a few songs right now.
Great. Great. Now, who do you listen to? What groups do you listen to influence your music?
Mostly Rush, Journey, and AC/DC.
Okay, well, thanks for being with us. I hope you all have a great summer. And let's join Shari.
Today I'm going to tell you what some of your favorite celebrities plan to be doing over the summer. Actor Todd Bridges of TV's Diff'rent Strokes plans to tour New Mexico this summer, and he's going to do it all on horseback. One Day at a Time star Valerie Bertinelli intends to fix up her new house and do a little touring with her rock star husband, Eddie Van Halen. Actor Timothy Hutton from the movie Taps plans to bicycle through England and Scotland this summer with some friends. Actress Lisa Welchel from the TV show Facts of Life is going home to Texas, and she hopes to start writing a book. Dukes of Hazzard star John Schneider is getting ready to record another record over the summer. Catherine Bach, also from the Dukes of Hazzard, is going to make a record this summer too. It'll be her first, so she's getting some tips from John. Actor Philip McKeon from the TV show Alice is just going to relax and play his guitar. And Dallas star Charlene Tilton is expecting a baby in the fall, so she's going to be decorating the nursery and getting everything all ready for the new baby. That's all what the celebrities are going to be doing over the summer.
Boy, I would like to do what Todd Bridges is doing, riding through New Mexico on
horseback. Oh, wouldn't that be great?
That sounds great.
Yeah.
Well, we also talked to some students from the Queen Bee School in Glendale Heights about what they're doing this summer, and here's what they had to say.
My name is Frank Brandisio. I'm 12 years old. This summer, I'm going to Grand Canyon, and I'm going down with mules, and I'm going to California, too.
My name is Joe Bongiorno, and I'm 11 years old. This summer, I would like to go to the swamp and catch frogs, and I hope I enjoy it.
My name is Ami Dave, age 11. This summer, I'm going to amusement park, and I hope I go on every ride.
My name is Billy Fallon. I'm 11 years old. This summer, my dad and I are going to Canada fishing. Boy, I hope I catch a big one.
My name is Heather Kuhn. I'm 11 years old. This summer, I'm going camping in Michigan with my family, and we're also going to move to Geneva.
My name is Michael Zatorre. I'm 11 years old. I'll be playing baseball against some other teams, and I hope we win them all. I hope I get a chance to go swimming.
My name is Pam Bear, age 11. I am going to Wisconsin to go rafting and tubing on the white waters, and I hope I don't tip over.
My name is Tom Rodkey. I'm 12 years old. This summer, I would like to help my mom with a new baby, and I'm real excited.
Hey, now there's a nice thought. And in today's music, there's another nice thought. The song we're going to hear is called Ebony and Ivory. It was written by former Beatle and super-songwriter Paul McCartney. Paul said he wrote this song to show how all people can and should live together. And to help make his point, he wanted a black singer to record it with him. He made the perfect choice by asking Stevie Wonder to join him. These two giants in the music world have always admired each other, and now that they've teamed up, they make beautiful music together. Let's listen now to Paul McCartney and Stevie Wonder singing Ebony and Ivory.
Bad in everyone. We
Paul McCartney and Stevie Wonder with Ebony and Ivory. Mm-hmm. You know, when that song was released, it only took about 3 weeks for it to go right to the top of the Billboard charts.
Well, that shows you how good it is.
And you can tell by listening to it.
Yeah, well, we're going to be giving you Paul McCartney's address later on in the show. We'll also be visiting Brookfield Zoo and making some neat summer treats.
So stay with us for lots more fun today on Kidding Around.
Kidding Around will return after these messages.
Woodsy Owl, with a bird's eye view of America's beautiful schools, playgrounds, and parks. But look what happens when grown-ups and kids don't give a hoot about pollution.
But Woodsy, what can we do about litter?
And vandalism!
Just spread the word. Give a hoot. Don't pollute. And if you see litter, please, pick it up. Because if you don't give a hoot,
who will? In the city or in the woods, please keep America looking good.
Hoot, hoot.
America's favorite cops are on the move.
Somebody's got to save the universe.
For more thrilling adventures on ships, patrolling the streets with a style all their own.
Then you jump and you'll kill yourself.
Risking their lives.
Watch out, John, look out!
And defying death. They always get their man.
Get a left hand on your head.
And usually their women. John Baker and Ponch Poncherello keeping the highway safe on ships.
Got it.
Ship, Sunday at 7 on Channel 5.
These girls are gonna teach you the facts of life.
What a novel idea.
This is gonna get good.
It's a lesson in more than just the birds and the bees.
Wow.
Just in time for the good stuff.
What?
It's the facts of life.
Good life. Good life.
Love it.
Oh, yeah.
Facts of Life, Wednesday at 8 on Channel 5.
Tropic World, it's a jungle in there. Tropic World, if you dare, wander through a tropic home where jungle beasts are free to roam. Under one roof, no glass, no steel. Stand so close, you can almost feel. Tropic World, it's something new. Tropic World, at the Brookfield Zoo, step inside if you dare. Tropic World, it's a jungle in there.
Now back to Kidding Around.
Well, one great thing you can do over the summer is visit the zoo.
Yeah, that's right, and there's two great zoos you can choose from. There's either the Lincoln Park Zoo or Brookfield Zoo. Both of them are really neat.
You know, out of all the animals that we have found out about over this past season from both zoos, have you got any favorites?
Oh, definitely. I think the one from, you know, that Dr. Fisher always brings in from Lincoln Park Zoo, I love the baby lion.
Oh, wasn't he cute?
And also the owl monkey.
Yeah.
Big eyes. And I think from Brookfield Zoo, I really like the zebras. I really enjoy them.
Well, of course, my favorite has always been the elephant.
Oh, yeah.
But also, when Shari and I visited the Brookfield Zoo just recently, we talked to Barbara Woodhouse, who is a trainer at Seven Seas, all about the sea lions. There you go. Who's this right here?
That's Julie. She's all our right. Adult female here.
Well, Julie, you're gorgeous. And Brenda, you're not so bad yourself. Listen, you have great control over these animals.
Well,
how long have you been working with them?
I've been working here about a year and a half.
Yeah? Now, most I saw you just giving hand signals.
Right.
Now, how do they learn to interpret that?
Okay, what we do is when we're teaching a behavior, we go along, and once they're near the step of being completed, then we start adding a hand signal. They don't work off of voice cues. The only voice cues they know is maybe their name and up and down off their seat. So once their behavior is almost completed in training, then we add a hand signal. And every time they do their behavior, we add that hand signal. Once they see the behavior, they start to anticipate that's what they're supposed to do. And that's how you add a hand signal to a behavior.
Now, at what age can you start training a sea lion?
You can start at almost any age. As a matter of fact, our two little ones are only 2 years old.
And
we got them a year ago. And so they came in when they were about a year old. The reason they were about a year is one was a beached animal, it was stranded, and it was found on the coast of California, and it was brought to a park where it was rehabilitated. And the other one was born in the park. And so we waited until they were healthy enough, and all their checks went through, and then they were sent here to keep Julie company.
Where are sea lions native of?
California sea lions are native from California.
Well, that would make sense.
Right. That's
well,
where
else
from.
Are they found?
They're found up and down along the coast, sometimes in South America, different types of sea lions. But the California sea lion, mainly along the coast of California.
Do they have a long lifespan? Do
they live to be about 30 years old. And your female will weigh about 250, and your adult male will weigh up to 600 pounds.
You're kidding.
They're real big animals.
Boy, will they stay that active? Or?
They'll pretty much stay that active, yeah. As long as you have other animals in with them, then they do a lot of
shall
playing
we get,
around.
They're here for a little more fish. Shall we give them
she's
one
ready
more,
to eat.
There you go. Hey-o. What about the little guys? Are they intimidated at all by the big girl here?
Not at all. When they first came, they were, and then one of them just took charge and started telling her what to do, and so they get along just great now. They have a definite pecking order, that's for sure.
Well, thank you very much for showing us your wares, and thank you too, girls.
Thank you.
Oh, they're great.
Aren't they wonderful?
Yeah,
I love them. Yeah.
Well, right now it's time to make some delicious summer treats with 10-year-old Jenny Joswiak from Chicago. And Jenny's going to show us how to make some delicious banana boats today. How you doing, Jenny?
Okay.
Do you cook a lot at home?
Not a lot, but sometimes I'll cook with my mother.
Oh, that's good. How long have you been making these banana boats?
About a year now.
About a year? They really do look good. What are some of the ingredients you need to make them?
All you need is a few marshmallows, chocolate chips, and a banana.
And depending kind of on how much you want, right?
Yeah.
Okay, what's the first thing we got to do?
First you just take and you slip the banana down the middle, making sure not to cut the banana in the half. Then you have to open it up some.
Okay. Ooh, messy, huh? Okay.
And then you take the chocolate chips and you put them real deep down into the banana.
Ooh, does that look good? Do you mind if I help you?
Go ahead.
Okay.
Depends on how many chocolate chips you want.
Okay.
And then you take your marshmallows, or you can use marshmallow cream, and you just spread it all the way along the banana.
Okay. These aren't bad. Okay. All right. Okay, what do you do after this?
And then you take some more chocolate chips and just put a few over the banana.
Okay. And I bet if you like chocolate, you can put on as much as you want.
Yeah. Huh? Depends how much you like chocolate.
Okay. All right, now what do we do after we get it to here?
All you do now is you stick in the oven at 350 degrees. And it doesn't matter if you preheat the oven, and you keep it in until everything melts, so you see everything that melts.
Do you know about how long that is?
It'll take between 5 to 10 minutes.
Okay. Well, we have one in there in the oven right now. Let's take a look at it. Mm-hmm. Now, obviously, it turns out pretty different looking, doesn't it?
Yeah, the banana will turn a little brown, but it doesn't really change the taste.
Oh, well, that's good. It looks really good. How do you eat one of these things?
You just take a spoon and stick it up.
Like this. Am I doing this right?
Mm-hmm.
I
don't want to. Go ahead.
Okay.
Some banana.
Okay. There we go. Set it on it. Ready? Here it goes. Cheers. Mmm, is that good? I bet you can put all kinds of other toppings on it,
too. Yeah, you could put nuts, ice cream, or raisins, or whatever you want.
Anything you like. Well, Jenny, thanks a lot for joining us. I really appreciate that you could show us how to do this. And if any of you would like to know the recipe for these delicious banana boats, you can write in and let us know. Why don't we join Steve now?
We're going to take a look at some more of your terrific artwork while we listen to Freeze Frame by the J. Giles Band. Artwork. And now, of course, it's
mail time! Yay! And first up, I have some medals here, and the first one's from Corey Hedgebeth of Gary, Indiana. What do you get when you cross a bee with a laser?
What do you get when you cross a bee with a laser?
A stingray. And here's another one from Mike Hansen of Wilmington. What book do you read when you have a cold?
What book do you read when you have a cold?
Science fiction. And here's another one from Jenny Pabian of Wheeling. What is a cow's favorite motorcycle?
What is a cow's favorite motorcycle?
A Kawasaki.
Okay. All right, well, I have a few of them here. This one is from Charmaine Horst of Schaumburg. What has 8 feet and can sing?
I don't know. What does have 8 feet and sings?
A quartet. Oh. All right, how about this one from Dan Blakeman of South Holland, Illinois? Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Ivan.
Ivan who?
Ivan working on the railroad.
Oh, no.
Okay, how about this one here from Michelle Nagorski of Chicago? Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Diesel.
Diesel who?
Diesel will be the last joke today.
Oh, yay. Well, we got a whole bunch of requests for singer-composer Paul McCartney's address. You can write to Paul McCartney in care of Wings Fun Club, Post Office Box 4 Up, London, W1A4 Up, England. That's to Paul McCartney in care of Wings Fun Club, Post Office Box 4 Up, London, W1A4 Up, England.
Gotta be one of the strangest addresses we've ever given.
And I get to give it.
And it keeps us up,
doesn't
it?
All right, yeah.
Well, even though this is our last show of the season, we'd really like it if you keep sending in your jokes, riddles, pictures, and poems. If you've got an idea for the show, if you've got a talent or hobby and think you'd like to be on the show, write and let us know about yourselves. Also, if you know of a good sport we could honor next year, let us know that too. You can write to
Kidding Around, WMAQ-TV, 19th floor of the Merchandise Mart, Chicago, Illinois, 60654.
Thank you for all those cards and letters.
All right, woo! We have come all to the right. end of another show and oh. end of another season.
Yay!
I want to thank all of our guests for being with us today on this special day, and mm-hmm. thank you for joining us, too.
And remember, you can watch all of our Kidding Around reruns all summer long, and that's on Saturdays at noon and Sundays at 7 o'clock in the morning.
That's right. And we're going to be back with lots more fun and all new Kidding Around shows starting on Saturday, September 18th and Sunday, September 19th.
So I hope all of you have a great summer.
We'll see you then.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. And you'd like to be on TV, just write to us. Kidding Around, WMAQ-TV, 19th floor of the Merchandise Mart, Chicago, 60654.
Campfire youth and adults have been growing together for over 70 years, learning, sharing, and having fun. Help Campfire youth build a bright future. Put some campfire in your life.
When you think video, one man to know, Precision Video.
Precision Video presents Sony, the people who brought you the Walkman. Now, Precision Video brings you the complete line of Walkman, including FM stereo receivers, cassette players, and recorders, priced from an incredibly low $89.95. On display, in stock, and on sale through Saturday. Don't miss it.
Precision Video.
On Manheim Road in Bellwood.
Or Golf and Roselle in Hoffman Estates.
Discover 500 years of history at the Chicago Historical Society. Revolution. Expansion. Settlement. Politics. Destruction. Pride. Growth. Traditions. It's all waiting for you at the Chicago Historical Society. Clark Street at North Avenue.
Fame will dazzle your eyes. Fame will touch your heart. Thursday.
Thank you.
I'm Scott Baio, and this is Where Moving. And today we're at Marineland in Palos Verdes, California, because we're going to be meeting an old buddy of mine that used to hang out here a lot. So roll that film.
And over here we have Marineland.